Hi friends, welcome to Tackle Knowledge channel. So today we are going to discuss class 6th part 2 chapter 1 activity 4. From all the food items you have listed in table 1.3, choose those items whose ingredients are obtained from plants. So we have to take the table 1.3 food items we have to collect. Choose those items whose ingredients are obtained from plants. So we have to choose the ingredients which are obtained from the plants. Which part of the plants? So from which part of the plant the ingredients are obtained, we have to see. Identify these and list the food items and plant parts as shown in table 1.4. So we have to see the 1.4. Plant parts as food. Brinjal curry. Plant parts as food. Food items with the plant as the major source. Ingredients or sources, plant parts which gives us the ingredients. So if we see the brinjal curry, we need a brinjal, chili as a spice, any other, oil from groundnut, mustard, soya bean, any other plant. So we have to need all these ingredients. Plant parts which gives us ingredients. So the brinjal is a fruit and chili is also a fruit. And the oil which are obtaining from the groundnut, mustard, soya beans, all these are seeds. Okay. And for idli, we need a rice urad dal, which is a, both are the seeds. Chicken curry, chili as a spice, this is the fruit. Oil has obtained from a seed. Kheer, for the kheer we need rice sugar. Okay, rice is a seed and sugar is a stem. Roti chapati we are getting from atta. Atta is from seeds only. Okay. Maggi is from wheat, chili as a spices. So wheat is a seed, chili as a spices is a fruit. So these are the examples, some of the examples of plant parts as a food. Okay. Next, activity 5. Take some dry seeds of moong dal or chana, put a small quantities of seeds in a container filled with water and leave this aside for a day. So we have to take a dry moong dal or a chana. Okay. Chana, this is the chana and these are the moong dal. Okay. So we have to take the dry seeds. We have to put a small quantity of seeds in the container. So we have to put this small quantity of seeds in a container with water and leave aside for day. So we have to add water and leave it aside for a day. Next day drain the water completely and leave the seeds in the vessels. So for next day we have to, after removing the water, we have to wrap these seeds in a cotton cloth. Okay, wetted cotton cloth. Following day, do you observe any changes in the seeds? So following day we will be observing some changes in the seeds. Okay, a small white structures may be obtained. So small white structures we can observe following next day. Okay, out of the seeds, if so the seeds have sprouted. So the white structure which is obtained from the seed is, we will be calling it as a sprouted out. Okay. Next, if not washed the seeds in water, drain the water and leave them aside for another day. So if some of the seeds which are not sprouted out, again we have to give water and drain the water and then leave them aside for another day so that remaining seeds can be obtained as a sprouts. Okay. Covered with a wet cloth. Next day seeds, see if the seeds have sprouted. So next day we can see that the sprouted has obtained. After washing these sprouted seeds you can eat them. So after washing these sprouted seeds we can eat it. They can also be boiled, add some spices and get a tasty snack to it. So if we cannot eat the raw ones, we can boil them and add some spices and we can taste it. Okay. Do you know where honey comes from? So from where the honey is coming? Have you seen a beehive where so many bees keeping buzzing about? So if we see the bees, they are buzzing a lot, right? So these bees collect nectar sweet juice from flowers, convert it into honey, store it in their hives. So this bees are going to collect nectar from flowers. Okay, flowers. So these nectars are obtained from the flowers afterwards, which is converted into a honey. This honey is stored in the beehives. Flowers and their nectars may be available only for a part of the year. So if we see the flowers and their nectar, it is stored for us some part of the year. Okay. So bees store this nectar for their use all through the year. So to store this honey for their future use. Okay, when we find such beehives, we collect the food stored by the bees as honey. So if we see these beehives, we are going to collect from this beehives. Okay, the honey is collected from this beehives. Activity 6. So now we will be seeing the activity 6. Several animals are listed in table 1.5. For some of them, the type of the food they eat is also given. Fill in the blanks in the table. So this is the table which we have to fill. Here is the example which I have taken for you. Buffalo, grass, oil cake, hay, grains. Okay, food animals eating. The buffalo will eat only grass, oil cake, hay and grains. Cat will eat small animals, birds, milk. Okay, rat is eating grains, fruits. Lion, animals. Tiger is also eating animals. Spider is eating insects. Housefly will eat insects. Cow is again eating grass, oil cake, grains, hays. Okay, human beings are eating grains, fruits, vegetables, animals, etc. Butterfly is eating nectar of the flowers. Okay, crow will eat grains, small birds, other houseflies, fruits, grains, vegetables. These are the food which animals eat in their daily life. Okay, next we will be seeing the activity 7. Have a look at table 1.5 and group the animals entered here are as follows. Place animals which eat only eat or plant product in the group 1. So in the group 1 we have to place the animal which is eating only the plants. Okay, only the plants as a food source. What are they? They are the buffalo. Okay, next, what else? Buffalo, cow, then housefly, butterfly, all these comes under group 1. If we see the group 2, these animals are called carnivores, which are eating the animals which eat only animals. So group 2 comes only which are eating the animals, that is lion, tiger and spider. Okay, next, crow. All this comes under the group 2. Okay, next, third one. Do you find some animals which eat both plants and animals? Both plants and animals are eaten by the human beings. Okay, this comes under the omnivores. Prepare a table in the table 1.6 and enter these separately in the three columns as shown. So we have to place all these columns. Okay, by seeing table 1.5 we have to place all the animals in these three groups. Pehle wants to know where you would place human beings while filling in the table. So she wants to know where the human beings are filled. So human beings are filled in the omnivores place. Okay, so human beings are omnivores because they depend on both plants and animals. Okay, we know that there are many amongst us who do not get sufficient food. So there are lots of people who do not get sufficient food in our country. So we need to find ways by which more food can be produced in the country. So we need to find more ways to produce the food in our country. Okay, that will not be enough. That is not enough. Not only we are producing the food, we will need to find ways to ensure that this food is made easily available to each one of us. We have to produce the food in a large amount of quantities and then we have to ensure that it should be available for each one of us every day. Now next we will be seeing about this summary. There is a lot of variation in the food eaten in different regions of the India. So we will be eating a lot of variety of foods in the different regions of India. Okay, main source of our food are plants and animals. Animals which eat only plants are called herbivores. So animals which are eating only the plants as their food, we'll be calling it as a herbivore. Okay, animals which eat only animals, we'll be calling it as a carnivores. Animal which eat both plants as well as other animals, we'll be calling it as a omnivores. Okay, so that's it friends. If you like my video, please kindly like, share, subscribe, and if it is helpful, please share it with your friends also. Thank you so much. Bye bye.